does this tube thing work?
Air pressure.
Are you from the future?
Have you ever noticed the pneumatic tubes they use in bank drive-thrus? There's just something about them that makes an everyday errand feel a little science fiction. In today's Brighter Idea, we'll feel the pressure behind pneumatic tubes. Pneumatic tube systems like this one have been around since the 1850s, and they were used in cities all over the world for more than a century. The Postal Service used pneumatic tubes to move mail between offices, and NASA used pneumatics to send memos in the decades before emails. Today, pneumatic tubes can still be found in hospitals, pharmacies, and banks.
The science behind pneumatics is actually pretty simple. Fluids, like air or water, move from areas of high pressure to areas of low pressure.
It's like drinking through a straw. As you suck the air out of the straw, you create an area of low pressure in front of the liquid. The liquid in the bottle moves up the straw to even out the pressure. Pneumatic tube systems work the same way. The tubes are airtight with a hatch on both ends. The money goes into a sealable canister with flexible rings that hug the sides of the tube. When a teller wants to send something through the tube, they place the canister in the hatch, close it, and press a button that turns on a fan on the other end of the tube. The fan drives the air out of the tube through a vent, creating an area of low pressure in front of the canister. The higher pressure air behind the canister rushes towards the area of low pressure in front of it, pushing the canister to the other end of the tube. The tube closes, the fan stops, and the air pressure evens out so the customer can open the hatch and retrieve the canister.
Thanks for watching. Want to learn more about air pressure? Click here for a high pressure experiment that you can do at home. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more videos from the Cade Museum.